Yet another anti-vax right-winger has died from COVID-19 this week. This time, it was popular podcast host, a man by the name of Douglas Kuzma, who his podcast, it was called, Frog News Network. And he called his listeners froganites. And he came down with COVID. He had been pushing conspiracy theories about COVID for a year. Came down with COVID. Took a turn for the worst, as his allies say, back in December. And then he passed away from it. Now, before I go into my usual diatribe here, let me also point something else out. Let's talk about where Mr. Kuzma caught COVID. He caught it during a recent, basically, conspiracy event that took place in Texas, the Reawaken America tour, that featured prominent right-wing idiot talking heads. And short time after the event ended, a lot of people ended up very sick because they caught COVID, and that is where it is believed that Mr. Kuzma caught COVID. But being that this was a Q-supported event down in Texas, nobody wanted to believe they actually caught COVID. So instead, they posited the conspiracy that they had all been poisoned by anthrax. That's how deep down the rabbit hole they had gone when they were in a large indoor shoulder-to-shoulder space and then all got sick from the virus that's been going around the globe for 2 years now. Their immediate reaction wasn't, oh no, we got COVID. It was, oh no, we've been poisoned with anthrax. Well, Mr. Kuzma did not die from anthrax. He did, in fact, die from COVID. His daughter said, I really loved him and I would do anything for him. He was a great father. That's the part of this story that got me. Every time. I guess I'm just a sucker for that. Even though this man was spreading conspiracy theories and fake information that undoubtedly led to people taking unnecessary risks, possibly getting infected and possibly dying from COVID too, because of his advice. In spite of that, there is still a part of me that feels a little bit of sympathy here. Mostly for his family. Because it's not their fault. And now, they've lost a father. Possibly lost a grandfather. I don't know about his extended family, but maybe a brother has lost a brother, a sister lost a brother. I don't know. But we do know that he did, in fact, have family. And he's gone now. For no reason. He should not have died. Had he protected himself, you know, gotten the vaccines, worn a mask, avoided these crowded spaces, he'd still be alive today. I have no doubt in my mind this man would still be alive today. And even though I disagree with everything he stood for, I would prefer to have him be alive than be dead. No more dead people from COVID, I say. I don't care. I don't care if you're somebody I call out on this show every day. I don't want you to die from COVID. That's where I'm at, because I still have some sympathy. Sure as hell isn't as much as I had 6 months ago, but I do still have some, and I do feel bad for the family. And nobody should have to go through what these people are now having to go through. It's unfair to them. So for the love of God, protect yourself. Do what you can. If for some reason you cannot get the vaccine, then continue wearing masks. Get the N95, the KN95, whatever it is. Get those. Stay away from crowded places. Do what you can to avoid exposing yourself to the virus. And if you can get vaccinated, still do all those other things and get the vaccine and the booster. That is the best advice I can give, because no family should have to bury a loved one because they bought into idiotic right-wing propaganda. But it's happening far too frequently in America today. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for fresh content every single day of the week. Just smash that subscribe button, and of course, don't forget to like, comment, and share the video.